Yo, as always, like, share, subscribe. I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers, y'all. I'm almost there. Need about 48 more. So subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. If you want to drop a donation, feel free. The links will be in the bio. Now, on the donations, I want to give a shout out to Greg Saudi, because it's one thing for a person to say they're going to do something, and it's another thing to do it. And I try to be a man of my word. And I got a shout out to Greg, because he's a man of his word. He said he's going to donate to the page every couple weeks. And he has, no matter what it was, he donated. So I can't do nothing but shout you out. And it means a lot to me for you to donate to the page, and just because you enjoy the content that I'm giving you. So shout out to you, bro. And everybody else that donated, if I didn't get you, I appreciate it. I can't say how much I appreciate that. But now let's just get into it. So Michigan has a bye week, and what I really wanted to talk about today is just a little bit about the playoff and about where I see Harbaugh has done with the offense and what he's been thinking, I guess. But with the playoff, I just want to talk about that real quick. What was it? OSU won, LSU, Bama, and then Penn State, I think. But those four teams, they have to play each other, so it don't mean much, I mean, right now. And with OSU, people saying OSU ain't that good, and they that good. When haven't they been that good? Come on, y'all. Like, let's just be real. When haven't they been that good? When Trussell got fired? Besides that, they've been that good. They lose two games. Them losing two games is a bad year for them. So let's just be real. Don Brown says our guys will be ready for them. They better be ready. You better have them ready. If they ain't ready, they going to wish they was. They going to wish they was ready. They going to be ready. I hope so. Our biggest rival, the game, I hope they ready. So they going to be ready. I hope so. But I don't like to talk trash. How can you talk trash about OSU when we haven't beaten them in who knows how long? But they that good. They deserve to be there. And I think they can play with anybody. But I digress on that. Let's see. Harbaugh, what I really wanted to talk about, though, for the most part, is Harbaugh and the Michigan podcast touched on this also, though. But it all makes sense, though. Harbaugh has reverted back to Harbaugh ball. And the reason he's done that is because Shea plays his best as a game manager. And I've talked about this all season, so I ain't going to spend too much time on it. But that's just what it is. Harbaugh sees that Shea can't lead the team. He can't be a field general. He can't throw. You can't trust him to throw the ball, come out throwing, and throw 35, 40 times and just, you know, throw it downfield, intermediate, to the flats, screens. You can't trust him to do all that stuff. And so he's reverted back to Harbaugh ball, which means pound the rock. Even if it means you giving up points because your defense is tired or whatever, just keep pounding it, keep pounding it, keep pounding it. Hopefully it wears down the defense, and have Shea make a throw here, a throw there, a throw there, and throw it maybe 20 times. If the running game isn't working. If the running game is working, he might not throw it 15 times. That's good. you throw it about 12 times and we'll get out of here. Good job, Shea. But if the running game isn't working at all, he's going to throw about 25 times. But Harbaugh is still going to stick with the run and hoping it's wearing on him. It's slowly wearing on him. And playing it like that, to where you just keep it, keep trying to wear down the defense. But you can't do that. Certain teams, we're not going to be able to do that against, and we're just going to end up losing because he can't lead the team without a running game. He's not that good of a quarterback. He's just not that good. So that's just kind of what it is now. So us throwing downfield and wanting to take those shots, it's just not going to happen because Harbaugh doesn't trust him. He don't trust him enough to let him be to let him take over the offense like Jake Rudock did when he got to his halfway through the year. Then you saw Harbaugh starting to throw it way more to where you'd expect him to be running it, and he's coming out throwing it, slinging it. He don't trust Shea like that. He trusted Rudock enough to do that, and Rudock showed him, you can trust me to throw it down the field. Shea still hasn't thrown for 300 yards, so that's just part of it. We just played, who we just played? Maryland. Their defense is bad. Their run defense is bad. Pass defense is bad. And Shea had, what, 150 yards throwing? That's just what it's going to be. Harbaugh don't trust him enough to throw the ball. You can't trust him to throw a screen. He won't look. He'll just throw it. And, you know, he'll just throw it. There'll be a dude waiting right there. Thank you. He'll be waiting. He'll be waiting right there. He don't even look. He just faked it. What, he picked it? Yeah, he picked it, Shea. He was standing right there. But that's just what it is, you know. So, honestly, when I really think about it, I can't really knock Harbaugh for that because I don't trust Shea myself. Do we trust him? As fans, we don't trust him. So, why do we expect Harbaugh to trust him? So, Harbaugh reverts to what he knows. I'm going to run this ball. Trust that my running backs don't fumble it, and I'm going to turn Shea into a game manager. You throw it here, you throw it a couple times here and there. So that's what it's reverted back to, and when I really just think about it, I can't knock him for doing that. I mean, I can because, well, I really can't because you get a guy and you expect him to get improved. And he doesn't improve, and you see what he really is. But honestly, if I was to do that, if I was just revert to a running game like we're gonna do and like he's done, I probably would start Dylan because Dylan is gonna help the running game because he keeps it on the read. But I really don't like to talk about the backups because they're not going to play. I mean, people say, oh, Dylan can't throw. And then Dylan gets in for a quarter. And he might be 2 of 4 or 2 of 5. I've seen Shea start off plenty of first halves and be 2 of 5 or 3 of 7. So you can't take that and say, oh, he looks like Shea does. Except he will keep it. Except he runs the read exceptionally well. So, just off that, me personally, I would play the backups because their upside is bigger. Shea is gone next year. This year, honestly, the way I feel, 10-2, that would be an okay season. But it's all about the playoff to me, y'all. Like, bowl game, going to a bowl game or the Rose Bowl or whatever. If we're not in a playoff bowl game, the bowl game is a overhyped exhibition. I'm just going to be 100 with how I feel. If y'all feel differently, just tell me in the comments or whatever. But the bowl game don't mean nothing to me, y'all. I'm just being real. It really don't mean nothing to me. So, once we're out of the playoffs, which is after you lose 2 games, you're pretty much out of the playoff. Okay, it's time to get ready for next year. Shea, it was good, whatever. Come sit down. Dylan, Joe, it's time to see what the future is. If you, whoever plays lights out, and if you play bad, I will be putting Joe in. Joe, if you play bad, I will be putting Dylan back in. We finna see who the future. Whoever plays the best the rest of the year has the upper hand going into spring practice and so forth and so on. That's how I would do it. Hey, college football, you can waste your time. Okay, waste the rest of the year with Shea, who will be gone next year. So him putting up numbers and we still done lost 2-3 games and we end up in the Gator Bowl or Who Cares Bowl. No, time to get ready for next year. Thanks, Shea. Take a seat. Thanks for coming. Dylan, Joe, McNamara, time to see what you got. It's time to do some learning on the field. Oh, you can't put him in the game against Notre Dame. Why I can't? Dylan played last year when Shea got hurt against Notre Dame. Get back in there. You can't put him in against this team. Yeah, you can. He on the college team. Why I can't put him in the game? Ooh, that's too much of a rowdy crowd. You can't put him in against Penn State wideout. Yeah, I can. Get in the game. It's soft stuff. You can't play him because of this. You can't play him. What are you on the team for if I can't play him? Put these dudes in the game. Big time football. You came to Michigan. Guess what comes with it? Rowdy crowds. 100,000 crowd in crazy atmosphere. ESPN prime time. Now, if you didn't want to be on primetime with 100,000 home fans or away fans in your face screaming, you shouldn't have came to Michigan. Simple as that. You shouldn't have came to Michigan if you didn't want that, if it's too much to handle. So I don't care if you're a freshman, senior, sophomore, junior, whatever, get in the game. Time to see what you're made of. Show me what you made of. I know if we can't see, you can't put him in against Penn State. You can't play him against OSU. Okay, so what if somebody get hurt? Then what? Oh, he's got to play now. I don't want to hear that. Yeah, you play him. I don't care if he's a freshman or whatever. If he's on the team, get in the game. If he can't play, why he on the team? Simple as that to me, but everybody want to make it, these are kids, come on, it's football. You can play it or you can't. It ain't no age to who can play. You can play it or you can't. It's simple as that. But it's just how I feel, you know. If I'm a coach, I don't have all this time to waste. Right now, to me, we wasting time with Shea. 10-2, what? 10-2, 9-3 season. It's okay. I mean, but to me, we wasting time. Thomas, see what these young dudes got, man. All this wasting time. Once you in college, once you done got two losses, man. Backups, y'all be ready to play. It's time to see what these, I ain't just going to end it on my seniors, but it's time to see what they got. Yeah, because you wasting time. Get these dudes repping. If they not red shirted and you're trying to keep that red shirt, get some of them dudes in the game and see what they got. Because next year will come and you don't want them to have to do all these growing pains next year. Then it's, oh, well, this is as if he's a first year starter and all this. No, get these dudes ready to play. And it's going to pay dividends next year. Just like Cam McGrone's going to pay dividends for next year. Dax Hill's going to pay dividends. Vincent Gray getting all this time is going to pay dividends. When these young dudes get time and they get see, okay, this is what college is. This is how the game feels. Then it's going to pay dividends the next year. So from what I've seen from Cam McGrone, I expect him to be a monster next year. The mistakes he's making this year, he shouldn't be making. If you're a player and as a human being in life, Not only on the football field, you want to improve and become a better person. Every day you want to be better than you were the day before. You want to be a better a person to everything, just in everything in life. You want to improve, especially on a yearly basis. I want to be healthier than I was the year before. So I got to work harder to do that. So when you are sitting on that bench, you can sit on the bench all you want to. The only one that really gets better on sitting on the bench is the quarterback. Most other players, and that's you hoping that they're going to get better. Most players, they need to be on the field because it's different sitting on the sideline and being on that field when somebody hitting you in the mouth. When you running plays and then all of a sudden you get smacked on the side of your head, it's different than being in the meeting rooms and stuff. So that's just how I feel about it. Like, two losses, it's time to get, I'm getting easy, the future in there. But that's just me. I'm not a coach. I don't coach college football. I'm just what they call it, armchair quarterback or armchair coach. But that's just how I feel. I mean, everybody got their way of thinking. I'm trying to think ahead. Because next year, we want to be great next year. Is next year, we got to wait for Dylan and Joe to get the game speed and all their mistakes? We're going to hear the same excuses next year. Oh, he's a first-year starter. This is Joe's first time getting starter reps. This is the same thing with Dylan. Dylan's never had starter minutes. Gonna be hearing the same excuses next year. Already got an excuse made up. Nah, forget the excuse. Sit Shay down. Put it in the future. But ain't no point of me harping on that because it ain't gonna happen. But that's just how I feel about it. And so, I mean, we got Michigan State. I ain't really gonna talk about them because I'm gonna do another video next week. So it ain't no point in me talking about this, but what? Let's see. Don Brown. I'm gonna talk somewhat about the game. Don Brown, you doing a lot of talk. We gonna see. You can say what you want about that team down south. They take it serious. They take it real serious, man. They don't play around when it comes to us. Even the fans. Me as a Michigan fan, I don't watch OSU stuff. But I got a lot of OSU fans that subscribe to my page. They like us being in misery. They like seeing me mad and talking about this stuff. So I give them respect because they've earned it. What's for me to talk about OSU for? Ain't nothing for me to talk about. They've been demolishing us. And some people, if the third quarter would have went different, if they didn't block that punt. But they did. And they went on to score like 18 in that quarter and another 20-some or another 17 in the fourth. I don't want to hear no ifs. If they didn't block the punt and then Shea threw a pick, but they did. They know if. They came out, kicked when it was a decently close game, and then they turned it on. They put up. I don't want to hear no ifs. If the ball was spotted, if Wilton Spate hadn't thrown two picks and a fumble, we blow them out 2016. But he did. I mean, if JT Barrett didn't get hurt 2017, we might win. But guess what? He did. Dwayne Haskins comes in, throws the ball, makes plays with his legs. If. I want to hear no if. Just do it. Just win the game. We have chances to win these games, but their players make better plays than us. Their coaches coach better than Harbaugh and his staff. So that's just what it is. I don't want to hear no excuses, man. I stopped making excuses. It just is what it is. So Don Brown, you shouldn't even be trying to talk about no OSU. Somebody asked you a question about OSU. We'll see on game day. I don't want to hear no we ready for them or none of that. No, I say we'll find out game day. I don't want to hear no guarantees. We'll find out game day. Y'all shouldn't even be wanting to talk. Game day, we going to see. We going to see what's up game day. I'm ready to knock somebody out. I don't want to hear. Y'all shouldn't even want to talk about that. You let them do the talking. They done earned the right to talk. You've been getting demolished for 10 years plus. Ain't no talking. This game, we see on game day. That's when we going to see what's up. See me on game day. Oh, yeah, Michigan this. Nah, I ain't talking, bro. I see you on game day when I'm ready to smash you in the mouth. Talk about, hey, what's to talk about? How can you even trash talk them? You can't trash talk them when they winning every year. They making big plays the whole sideline like they having a freaking Mardi Gras celebration over there. They know what's finna happen. We done blocked the punt. They over there having Mardi Gras. I'm seeing duck fucking balloons and spinners, all types of stuff over there. They finna blow us out. You see how hype they is? They know what's finna happen. They finna turn up. You got the nerve to talk. Man, please. We do hype stuff. Our sideline ain't even close to looking like that. Because they know what's finna happen. They finna turn it on and put on about 35 and a half. I don't want to hear no talk about OSU. Show me. Show me. Man, I don't want to hear no talking. I don't even want to hear you mention nothing about them. I wouldn't even answer no questions. Yeah, we gonna see on game day. That's all I want to hear. It's game day. Okay. How many more weeks we got to them? We'll see them game day. We'll see them when the game start. They ain't earned the right to talk stuff to OSU. None of these players, Harbaugh, none of them. Not even fans. We ain't got the right to talk. How can you talk trash to OSU fans? Only thing I didn't understand is why they watch our stuff. Why they watch Michigan fan pages and YouTubes. They enjoy us. They enjoy this. That's what I got out of it. They enjoy watching us being miserable about the seasons and all this. They enjoy it. And honestly, if we were beating them like that, maybe I would too. We haven't done it in so long. I can't say if I would or if I wouldn't. So yeah, that's all I got for y'all, man. That's all I got, man. I know I done went on a couple rants, but ain't nothing else to talk about. So I might as well rant. Ain't nothing else to talk about. So as always, like, share, subscribe. Subscribe. Trying to get to this 1,000. I can feel it. If you want to drop to the donation, drop a donation. Feel free. It's in the bio. The audio will be on Anchor and Spotify and all those. But as always, go blue.